Welcome to our home. We were very honored when Karen asked us to put together a small video to be part of the COVID artist support project. John has been retired from performing, but that Karen, she's quite a persuasive one. So we thought we would invite you into our home today. I've been slowly walking from our front door into John's bedroom, and this is to show you his collection. Is what usually makes people awe, his beautiful collection of violins, fiddles that he has made, gathered up, fixed up, been given. He works hard at making fiddles. He usually makes about 5 or 6 each winter. Jokingly said when he came up with the idea to build the first shelf in this bedroom that he could build one shelf and that would be the end of it. But as you can see, he's now gone all around the entire room and also managed to build a few out in his studio too. So we're inviting you into our very cozy, small home and are happy to be able to play some tunes and share some music with you. We have been in our cozy little home here since the pandemic hit, if you will, since March 17th. I've left the farm twice. John has stayed here the entire time. And it's been really reflective. We hope everyone is safe and well. And we hope that you enjoy these few tunes that we're going to play for you today. I will not be on camera as I need a haircut. How many people can say that? The COVID-19 has not been conducive, I should say, to things like that. So we are going to proceed with doing this and I will remain off camera. You will, though, get to see John's happy smiling face throughout. Anyway, we hope you enjoy this. Again, we hope everyone is safe and thanks to GDI for this initiative.
Welcome to our home. We're going to play a few tunes for you this afternoon and hope you enjoy some of them. The first one I'm going to play is called the Bucksaw Waltz, and this is a waltz I wrote because it reminded me of a bucksaw we used to use for cutting firewood for the house. And here's a Bucksaw Waltz.
Thank you.
It's called Moses' First Change. Now, that Moses White was a square dance scholar out of Edmonton, and I wrote him this tune years and years ago. And this is called Moses' First Change. And then after that, I want to play a tune that I wrote up in Turtle Lake when I was playing with Vicky's mom and dad. And this called the Turtle Lake Swing. Okay, here is Moses' First Change. Thank you.
next tune we're going to play for you comes off of John's recording Dedications, and I have a little bit of a story about that one. He had the notion in 2009 to maybe gather up a bunch of old traditional Métis tunes and make a recording of them. I was quite apprehensive, as they're very hard to chord to and to learn. And so when he kind of was getting organized, I said, you know, you need to go out to your studio and make a CD of these that the accompanist can practice with and be prepared for the actual recording. So off he went. And every night he would come in for supper and I'd say, well, how did it go? And he'd say, well, I didn't do much on the CD, but I wrote a new tune. And this went on for about 14 days. The end result was he wrote 12 tunes in 14 days. And we never did do the traditional Métis recording. Phew. just kidding. But anyway, he really did come in with some really good tunes. John has always said that when he writes a tune, he needs to play it and in order to name it, whatever. The one night he came in, he said, well, I've got this tune and I want to call it Reel de Claquette. So I asked him what that meant. And he said, well, loose translation, it was like the toe rubbers in, you know, his parents, a lot of Métis people used to put toe rubbers over their moccasins. And it reminded him of dancing and the moccasins and the toe rubbers. And so anyway, I grabbed the guitar and we ran through this tune. And boy, it was a little bit crooked and a little bit awkward to play. And so I have jokingly always called this tune the frickin' toe rubber reel, because it took me a little while to learn the chords. It is, however, a very good tune, and it is called Reel de Claquette. And John, let's give it a whirl.
Yeah, I want to dedicate this tune to all our Métis dance friends in Saskatoon. Les tonneurs, ne m'hétoc.
Sounds good. Keeping on with Dedications, this next tune, well, he may be known as the master of the Métis fiddle. Not all of his tunes come out sounding Métis. As he was writing all these tunes for Dedications, he came in one evening and he'd written a tune for a good friend of ours named Don Kermy. Now, this tune has a very Ukrainian feel to it. It's a ton of fun to play, very fast-paced, and it was an audience favorite when we used to perform on a regular basis. John? Let's play the Don Kermy polka. ¶¶
right, his next tune I want to play is a tune that I really enjoy playing, and it's my all-time favorite tune. And this tune was written by a slave in 1812 for his woman, and during the days of the Underground Railroad. And this is called Darling Nellie Gray.
Tunes that John didn't write and tunes that we really enjoy playing, I think we should play Sunshine and Flowers by Andy DeJarlis. Andy was a very well-known Métis composer, fiddle player, many, many recordings and many tunes out there that the fiddle world still plays to this day. John always loved his music and wanted very much to do a tribute CD to him, if you will. In 2011, we started on that process and we did complete it. It was hard to do. You need to get the rights to music, and a lot of Andy's is protected and hard to come by. And sadly, while this is one of our favorite Andy tunes, it did not make the recording because we couldn't get the rights to it. The recording, however, does have a bunch of great Andy tunes on it. So John, let's play Sunshine and Flowers, a wonderful foxtrot by Andy DeJarlis.
Good. Thank you.
And in keeping with Andy DeJarlis tunes, John did record a tribute to Andy DeJarlis in 2011. And John, on that recording, what's your favorite tune?
My favorite tune on that album is called The Raffled Wagon Polka.
The Raffled Wagon Polka. What is that supposed to mean?
Well, it could mean that the early settlers had covered wagons that were in disarray, most of them.
Oh, so like the settlers traveling with the covered wagons and things would get mixed up.
Yep.
Well, that's interesting. And another funny story behind the names of some fiddle tunes. So let's play the Raffled Wagon Polka. Wagon Polka. That's quite a different name. And as I said in the intro to that one, there's a lot of fiddle tunes out there with very different names. John is a prolific writer. He's written over 470 tunes. And I think I mentioned earlier, he tends to write them for people, places, and things. And so most of his names aren't too out there. And some of them people might question. It's very interesting if you look at a piece of John's sheet music. There's a little bit of a narrative down at the bottom, and it explains why he wrote the tune, and it's like a little roadmap, if you will. So that's very interesting if you have the opportunity to find that or discover it. This next tune we're going to play has a bit of a story to it, because speaking of, you know, tunes with different names, back in the days of Emma Lake Fiddle Camp, John came home one weekend after camp and said, "Oh, I got this cool tune that some of my friends from Manitoba taught me. It's called Little Johnny with His Bended Legs." And I said, "Well, what the heck kind of name is that for a fiddle tune?" And we assumed it sounded, you know, kind of Métis, dancey, whatever. It was written for someone that knew how to jig. And, you know, move ahead to getting ready to do the recording Traditionally Yours. And, you know, you've got to give credit to the authors, the composers. John reached out to those friends in Manitoba and they said, "Oh gosh, we don't know where that came from. Our fathers played it and our grandfathers played it. We've just played it for years. So we did all the research we could and just simply couldn't really find out any more about the tune. And then we were actually in the process of recording it when John was invited to play at an event, and I wasn't accompanying him at that particular one. And I was sitting in the audience beside a very, very elderly Frenchman. And John started playing that tune. And oh, he said, oh, mais oui, I have not heard that tune. And I'm like, oh my goodness, maybe I can find something out here. Now, he was very elderly, so I said, oh, do you know that tune? And he said, oh, yeah, yeah, mais oui, my family, we play that. I said, well, what do you call it? And he said, oh, it's called a Tijon avec pâte croche. So I said, well, I'm sorry, but I'm not French. What would the interpretation of that be? And he said, oh, you know, little Johnny bended legs. And I said, well, you know, that's what we thought it was called too. We then gave it just the traditional heading, if you will, and recorded it on Traditionally Yours. And after that recording came out, we received a letter in the mail one day from a gentleman that we had no idea who he was. And here was an entire little explanation, some very old documents. And it was actually a tune that was written in the early 1800s. And it was written for a young man that was going off to war. And back then, they wore metal guards around their elbows and their knees when they went off to war. And the original name of the tune is Little Johnny with His Banded Legs, because these bands were wrapped around their legs. So whether it's Little Johnny with His Banded Legs, Little Johnny with His Bended Legs, or Tijon avec pâte croche, we did record it on Traditionally Yours, and we'd like to play it for you now. I think it's time to slow things down a bit. I mentioned earlier that John is a prolific writer. He's written over 470 some original tunes. And this next tune was written for a very special person in our lives. And that person is Heather Vishloff. She is the administrative assistant for the John Arcand Fiddle Fest. I'm assuming that most of you know that we host an annual festival, second weekend in August each year. And sadly, this year, due to COVID-19, like so very many things, the festival is canceled. But we promise you we're going to hit the ground running in 2021 and bring you a really, really great show. Heather is just such a big part of what we do, and her assistance is just, it's immeasurable. And quite a few years ago, John wrote this waltz for her. And we had taken a bit of a hiatus from recording, if you will. John retired from professionally performing. And, you know, then you don't really have a place to sell as many CDs. A lot of things happening online these days. And so we just kind of laid low, and Heather's waltz and quite a few other tunes kind of piled up. And last year I said to him, you know, we've got all these great tunes. We really should make one more recording. And so we did. Weren't sure what to call the name of the album, but came up with number 17 because it was his 17th recording. And it allowed us to finally record Heather's waltz. So Heather, if you're out there listening, this one's for you. In case you didn't see the very beginning of this little video we're doing for you here, I brought you into our home and I showed you John's bedroom where he's got all of his fiddles hanging. That is a huge passion of John's. He spends all the late fall and winter, early spring months making fiddles. A person who makes a fiddle is called a luthier. And John, how many have you made to date?
I'm working on number 70.
Number 70? Oh. Yeah. So now you know why there were so many fiddles hanging on the walls in our house. And he has been playing one of his fiddles that he made. What number is that one, John?
32.
Number 32. He took a liking to that one a few years ago and has been playing it ever since. So getting back to more tunes on the recording number 17, John wrote a tune that he named Ward Allen. Now, Ward Allen was a well-known composer, and he actually composed a lot of really well-known fiddle tunes. Maple Sugar, the infamous Maple Sugar that everyone plays, Back to the Sugar Camp, and on and on. His music had a certain sound or feel, if you will, which a lot of composers' music does. And John got the notion to write this tune, and it made him think of that sound or feel, if you will. And so we call this tune Ward Allen.
It's called Yvonne Dumont. Yvonne was a good friend of mine, and we used to go to Badosh quite a bit. That's where I first met him, I think. Anyway, he was the Lieutenant Governor General of Manitoba at one point. And yeah, he's been a good friend ever since. Now, he's worked at the radio station, I think, in Manitoba, and he plays this tune quite a bit, and a lot of people really enjoy playing this tune, and a lot of kids really enjoy it. Here's Yvonne Dumont.
Thank you.
like to thank GDI for getting us to do this little show, and I hope people enjoy it, and we'll see you down the road somewheres. And anything you want to add?
I would like to send out a special thank you to David Morin from GDI. Living on an acreage has its benefits. Good internet is not one of them. So we had quite a few struggles to get this done for you folks. But thanks to Dave, he managed to pull it all together for us. And thank you very much. We hope you're all staying safe during this pandemic. Be safe, be careful, and we'll see you down the music trail. Bye for now.